The introductory words of Moshe Rabbeinu to Klal Yisrael before they embark upon the construction of the Mishkan, teaching them about Shabbos in general, and then specifics of the prohibition of Havara, of lighting a fire. So in the pure halachic world, there's a machlekes atanoim, why the Torah singles out Havara. Why does the Torah, out of all 39 melachos, only speak specifically, at least in Parshas Vayakel, about the prohibition of kindling a fire? But in the world of Machshava, so Chazal tell us, appears in the Zohar, that the phrase Lo Savar Eish B'chomash Rosechem B'Mashabos can be understood on multiple levels. It not only refers to the physically lighting of a match, or the driving of a car, turning on of a gas stove, but Lo Savar Eish B'chomash Rosechem has a deeper meaning as well, not only in the world of Halacha, but in the world of Hashkofa, that one should not be Maver Eish B'chomashabos. One should not kindle a fire within oneself, namely one should not get angry. Now, getting angry, we know, is something that, of course, we always frown upon, as I'll speak in very derogatory ways about the midah, the trait of anger. And yet, the Zohar draws our attention to the fact that B'yom HaShabbos, so that anger is even more of a problem, even more of a prohibition, even more of a violation. The Savar Eish published for sake of the fire of anger inside oneself. What is it about the meat of anger and Shabbos that are so contradictory to one another that the Torah, in a sense, has to single out in addition to the other 6 days of the week not to get angry, how much more so in Shabbos Kodesh? So, on one level, one can understand that anger is the antithesis of what the day of Shabbos is supposed to be, because also Shabbos Oneg, it's supposed to be a day of great delight, a day of great joy, a day of spiritual joy. And as such, of course, Kaas, the meat of anger, which takes us away from that ability to experience that sublime joy. Chazal tell us, Kalakoes, a person is angry, so he'll lose his Koach HaNavua, he'll lose his Koach HaChochma. So clearly, a person succumbs to the meat of Kaas and anger and Shabbos that's going to undermine the Oneg and the Shalom and all the beauty, the radiance of Shabbos Kodesh. Perhaps there's another reason why anger is so contradicted to the very essence of Shabbos. Chazal tell us, they call it koeis ki'ilu avid avedazar. If a person gets angry, he's as if he's an idol worshiper. Which idol did he worship? Say Chazal, lo yevcha el zar, v'lo seshtach v'el nechar. Vcha means within you. A person who gets angry is bowing down to none other than himself. So lost control that he gets angry. He is an Oved of a Zara of his own self. He is Oved to his own Midah. He has lost himself. Kalakois is an Oved of a Zara. But they, more than Shabbos, is of course the antithesis of a Zara. As I'll tell us, Kalmachalas, a Shabbos, can Oved of a Zara. Kal Shabbos for Hesia is Dino Ka Oved of a Zara. Because of a Zara denies the existence of a Kaddish Baruch Hu. Chil Shabbos denies the existence of a Kaddish Baruch as the Borei Olam. In fact, Rashi was writes that's the reason why there is a halachic principle called Kalah. Chil Shabbos for Hezia, public designation of Shabbos is like idolatry because it's rooted in the same chait. In Kas, although again not in the halachic world, it's not quite worshiping idols. Kas is not quite Chil Shabbos, but it smacks at these averas. It has some degree. Minute mouth, this trait of Ovid of Avodah Zarah, where a person is so taken over, so out of control of himself, he succumbs to a fit of rage. Such a person is, in a certain sense, Ovid of Avodah Zarah, lo yeh b'chol el zar. He's worshiping himself, he's worshiping his own midas rose, he's worshiping his own trait of anger he has not been able to overcome. When Shabbos of all days, the days when we acknowledge that we are not in control of the world. Days that we acknowledge that the Kaddish Baruch Hu is the Borei Olam. A person to put himself up on a pedestal and say that I have a right to be angry, I guilty to be angry, I was hurt, I was wounded, I was attacked, and entitled to be angry, that's diminishing Kaddish Baruch Hu as the center of the world. Kaddish Baruch Hu is the Borei Olam. And therefore on Shabbos itself, a day which should be devoid of any traces of idolatry, special azara, special mitzvah Torah. In addition to the halachic prohibitions of kindling fires on Shabbos, Chazal saw deeper meaning in this pasuk as well. One's mood, one's mindset on Shabbos sets the stage for whether the Shabbos will be a day of Shabbos Lashem, of Kodesh Lashem, or the person will become, in a very real sense, someone who is chalas a Shabbos, someone who does malach on Shabbos, someone who treats Shabbos in the antithesis of what Shabbos is all about. So the mitzvah of Savar Shechom Shosechem sets the stage for Eshem and Shabbos. Everybody, a wonderful, wonderful Shabbos.